MMA Inside the Cage, brought to you by Advanced Sports Labs. Expedite your blood work today at advancedsportslabs.com.
Welcome to MMA Inside the Cage, bringing the world of mixed martial arts straight to you. I'm your host, Cyrus Fees, and yes, I'm all by myself tonight. Well, that doesn't usually happen. Of course, Casey Ox and I is going to be joining us via satellite from Las Vegas throughout the show. I guess he missed his flight back to Tennessee. Kind of unprofessional, but, you know, we're dealing with Casey here.
Cyrus, you know exactly why I missed my flight, because I've been sitting in some room with hammers at my kneecaps trying to explain to them that it was you that lost the $5,000 on blackjack and then skipped town.
All right, Casey, you're sounding a little crazy right now. We'll check back in with you in just a few minutes. This last weekend was a huge weekend for the sport of mixed martial arts. And in our second round, we're going to talk all about the big two-day fight summit that featured an all-star cast of MMA industry stars. And later in the show, Casey will visit with one of the sport's greatest combatants. I'm talking about Wanderlei Silva, the Axe Murderer. And speak of the devil, Casey, why don't you go ahead and set us up for our big first interview this week?
Well, partner, I was elated to pick up that 25-minute sit-down interview with Kevin, the Monster Randleman, which incidentally you can take a look at on our YouTube channel right now. But man, take a look at the sparks as they fly when you mentioned another one of the industry's top names.
I'm standing next to Kevin, the Monster Randleman. We're talking the UFC legend, Pride legend, legend of the game. Fantastic to have you here on the camera, and we're talking about Advanced Sports Labs. We're talking about the Fight Summit. Talk about your role here, what you're doing here with the company, and what you're doing here at the summit.
First and foremost, I'm here to help Advanced Sports Labs get the awareness out. They're helping small business, small gym owners try and get their business on top.
Yeah.
Trying to help the small business, the small fighters that don't have the, you know, they don't have the jobs, but they'll help you get the blood work. If you guys don't know do not know what's Advanced Sport Labs about, you should go online and check them out, because I guarantee you they got something for you.
There's one fighter that tends to push your buttons at times, and you said you even wouldn't mind having a fight with him some days. In fact, I think it was a New York Minute you would make that happen. That is Tito Ortiz. He was at the awards last night.
He talked bad about a friend of mine, Mark Coleman, after one of his fights. Mark, you know, he was in a bad way, so he talked about him. And when I heard him talk about him, like, you suck. No, Tito, you suck. You act like you so tough, but you ain't really that tough. You can't talk to nobody if there's no one behind you. That's who you are. I stand by myself everywhere I go, and I'll beat anybody's tail if you talk junk to me. So please, anybody, put the money out there. I don't even need money. I don't need the money. This is one that I want for myself. So doesn't matter. I mean, regardless, I would just like to touch him. I would just like to touch him. That's it. He said a lot of bad things, and he's good at saying bad things about a lot of people that are good people. So what's that make you? That makes you kind of like a bully in my eyes. And you know what? I love kicking bullies. Let's make something happen.
Cyrus Fees, MMA Inside the Cage. You can find the entire sit-down interview on our official YouTube page. But right now, here it is, your MMA Inside the Cage Punch of the Week.
As a professional fighter, there's a lot of things that I need to be concerned about. I need to be concerned about my opponent. I need to worry about my fans. I don't want to have to be concerned about my blood work. That's why I go to Advanced Sports Labs, and I get my blood work done in an affordable manner. They get it done fast. They send it to the commission, they send it to the promoter, and they send it to me, so I have peace of mind knowing that everything's done properly.
As a promoter, they've taken away the headache of trying to get the blood work and get the results to the state. They have streamlined the process, and they do it at a great affordable rate for the fighter and for the promotion.
Expedite your blood work today at advancedsportslabs.com.
Are you ready, America? Then let's get it on with Fight Now TV. Your front row seat, 7 days a week to experience all the hard-hitting action, news, and entertainment from around the fight world. From world-class boxing events.
Here we go, the main event!
To mixed martial arts showdowns and other combat sports matchups.
Here we go!
Fight Now TV delivers the hits and more. Fight Now TV also offers unrivaled access to the fighters and insiders who make the fight game happen around the globe. As we go from the training camps to the weigh-ins, press conferences to the matchups, Fight Now TV is there before and after every bell. Fight Now TV also features original series found only on Fight Now.
There you have it.
Stop on by.
It's time, fight fans. Your channel has arrived. All the fights, all the names, all the action. Call your television provider and tell them you want to get it on with Fight Now TV.
MMA Inside the Cage, brought to you by Advanced Sports Labs.
Welcome back to our big recap from Las Vegas. Cyrus Fees and Casey Oxton and I will join us throughout the episode via satellite from Sin City. Now, when we first heard about the Fight Summit, we were instantly interested. All the biggest names in the industry showing off their products, and our sponsor, Advanced Sports Labs, of course, making a huge splash at this convention. Well, they had an all-star lineup of speakers at the Fight Summit, and here are just a few of them.
Casey Oxendown with MMA Inside the Cage. I'm here with the Ferguson boys, man. How are you guys doing? Up here at Fight Summit running around. What's going on?
It's awesome, man. Having a good time, dude. Loving it.
We're just doing pretty good. Just getting ready for Josh's fight Saturday night. The Ultimate Fighter finale. Just having a good time out in Vegas.
I'm right here with Amanda Lucas, rising MMA female star, star of Japan and all over the world.
Mostly, actually, I've been training in Vegas at Throwdown with John Wood. I'm also a member of the Scrap Pack, which is Gilbert Melendez's team in San Francisco. But I've really been spending a lot of time in Vegas. It's looking like I'll probably get a title shot for Deep in February.
Here with Ken Pavia, right here at Fight Summit. Man, you just finished a big seminar in there. Tell me what's going on for one of the hottest managers in all of mixed martial arts today.
Having some fun touching fans, touching people who want to get in the business, warning them against it, but having some fun here at the Fight Summit, and having fun now that I've sold the company, you know, sold to Paradigm Sports and just doing the booking for them, so enjoying life right now.
Here with Martin Kampmann, UFC veteran. Man, you know, it's like war after war with you, man. Of course, one of the nastiest cuts I've ever seen on any fighter in my life. They sewed you up, you went back to war, you fought Diego Sanchez, you're on a winning streak, and now it's Thiago Alves next, man. You know, what do you got planned for this fight?
Right now, I don't have too much planned. You know, I'm actually trying not to worry about the fight just yet at all. I'm just, you know, I fought last week, so right now I'm just, you know, I'm training. I trained this morning, but, you know, I came right from the In-N-Out Burger right before I got here, you know, so I'm just enjoying. I can eat whatever and not worry about fighting, you know. But, you know, once we get a little closer, I'm going to start watching his tapes. You know, he's a tough guy. He's a fierce competitor, and he always brings it. And I'm looking forward to going there and scrapping with
him. An old schooler here, Jamie Toney, man. I've known you for years. I've seen you around. You know, started out up in Ohio with George Gurgel. Now you have made your way out west, and you're training with the one and only Boss Rutten, one of my favorites, man. Tell me what it's like to train with Mr. Boss Rutten.
It is never a dull moment training with that man. You know, it's like he's up, he's down, he's making little funny noises when he's teaching. He's teaching you, you know, rhythms and stuff, and he's like bing, 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 bing. He's just all over the place. Never a dull moment. Totally enjoy it. Learning all the time. It's great.
So what, you know, let me ask you this. What? Tell me the truth. What does he bring to the table the most? I mean, he has impeccable skill. You know, he's been around the sport, you know, his entire life, but like you said, he has that mental aspect that makes you comfortable. It seems like it makes you happy to train every day. You know, what is it? What's the most important part of his training?
The most important part, one, is trying to be smarter than whoever you're fighting. You know, he's good at breaking it down. He's kind of like a Greg Jackson in a way, but that's not what Boss does. Boss doesn't go and corner all these guys all the time because he doesn't have time for it, but he lays it out in the gym. He studies who you're going to go fight. Everybody at our gym, he studies. He looks at it, you know, and he sends us emails. Check this out. Do this. Do that. And when you go to fight, you know that man has been, you know, scouting this guy, and he just totally lays it out on the line for you. And when you go in to train with him, it's just fun.
Now, on the other side of the break, we're going to get some great stuff from UFC megastar Wanderlei Silva. But before that, Casey, there was one man in particular at the summit that you had to get an interview with.
All right, Casey Oxendine here with MMA Inside the Cage at Fight Summit Vegas, here with the one and only Stitch Duran, the greatest cut man of all time. How are you doing today?
I'm doing great, man. Thanks for those accolades. It's kind of nice.
Yes, sir. So you're speaking here at the Fight Summit. Tell me a little bit about that, what you're going to go over, and what we should expect.
Well, I'm going to be a lot of speaking, but more education. I'm going to be doing a cut man seminar and showing the guys the proper way to wrap hands and how to use an end swell and you know, the medications that we use, and basically through Z, and I'll be doing a lot of questions and answering also, because there's a lot of myths that go with being a cut man, and I'm here to dispel those myths.
Nice. Well, now when you walked in here, I noticed you were going through your gear, and you had a couple of hand wraps sitting in your gear, and you said those might have belonged to Shogun.
Now then, not might have. They did belong to Shogun. That was a big fight with Dan Henderson and Shogun, and Osiris asked me how I ranked that as you know, one of my favorite fights, and by all means was, you know, the adrenaline is still there. Just talking about that, and but these wraps were real special because Rob Monroe is one of our new additions as a cut man in the UFC, and we're staying so busy, we're bringing in more people, and I didn't have the chance to wrap his hands, Shogun's hands, even though he wanted me to. So I brought Rob in and I introduced him to him, and Rob wrapped his hands. It turned out to be probably the greatest fight in MMA history, and at the end of the fight, you know, they were both so exhausted. I cut the wraps off a Shogun in the ring, and I had him, and I was gonna give him to Shogun, but he was, you know, they went straight to the hospital and all that. So I figured, well, the next best guy to give him to is Rob Monroe, and you know, he deserves it, and that just, you know, that's where they're going.
Very nice. Now, here in my hand, I have a roll of tape. Yep. And being a coach myself and knowing, you know, how important the tape is, this is a special kind of tape, and it's got your name attached to it. Could you tell me a little bit about this product?
Yeah, you know, that was designed by Ian Dixon, and he's the owner, creator of War Tape. And, you know, he found value in what I do in wrapping hands and all that, and wanted to know if we could kind of coexist in promoting this tape. And Tap Out Now has picked it up, and you'll be seeing it soon in the market.
Wow. Well, no doubt, man. Anything that has your name attached to it, you know, I'm sure it turns to gold because you are the best. I am here with the one and only Stitch Duran. This is Casey Oxendine, MMA Inside the Cage.
Yes, sir. Thank you so much.
As a professional fighter, there's a lot of things that I need to be concerned about. I need to be concerned about my opponent. I need to worry about my fans. I don't want to have to be concerned about my blood work. That's why I go to Advanced Sports Labs, and I get my blood work done in an affordable manner. They get it done fast. They send it to the commission, they send it to the promoter, and they send it to me, so I have peace of mind knowing that everything's done properly.
As a promoter, they've taken away the headache of trying to get the blood work and get the results to the state. They have streamlined the process, and they do it at a great affordable rate for the fighter and for the promotion.
Expedite your blood work today at AdvancedSportsLabs.com.
Are you ready, America? Then let's get it on with Fight Now TV. Your front row seat, 7 days a week to experience all the hard-hitting action, news, and entertainment from around the fight world. From world-class boxing events.
Here we go, the main event!
To mixed martial arts showdowns and other combat sports matchups.
Here we go!
Fight Now TV delivers the hits and more. Fight Now TV also offers unrivaled access to the fighters and insiders who make the fight game happen around the globe. As we go from the training camps to the weigh-ins, press conferences to the matchups, Fight Now TV is there before and after every bell. Fight Now TV also features original series found only on Fight Now.
There you have it.
Stop on by.
It's time, fight fans. Your channel has arrived. All the fights, all the names, all the action. Call your television provider and tell them you want to get it on with Fight Now TV.
MMA Inside the Cage, brought to you by Advanced Sports Labs.
Welcome back to the show. And yes, we are in the third round. It's time to impress the judges. And Las Vegas is the home to so many of the top fighters and gyms in the world today. And one of those gyms is the WAND Fight Team facility, headed up by none other than former Pride champion and UFC star Wanderlei Silva. Now, Casey, you are a huge fan of the Axe Murderer, and this interview is very special to you.
All right, it's Casey Oxendine here with Wanderlei Silva here at the Vaughn Training Center in Las Vegas, Nevada. Man, it's the Axe Murderer right next to me. I can't believe it. He's coming off a huge victory over Kung Lee back in the UFC. Man, it was beautiful. You know, you've got to be just elated with that fight, man, because you came out there. It was a tough fight. Kung Lee is highly touted, man. He's a legend, too. You go out there, you score that big knockout. Man, do you feel revitalized?
Yeah, no, I feel really good because that fights are really important for me, you know, and I have the back in the wall, you know, but some guys fighting better in that position, you know, and I don't want off that guys.
Wow, no, so you've done pretty much everything there is to do in a sport in your career, but with that victory, you know, they're opened some doors, some options. Are you looking to to make a title run again? Are you always there in contention? Are you just looking to fight? I mean, what is your goals in the future here?
No, my goal is compete. You know, I fight one fight in each time right now, and I don't know what's the plan from the UFC for me, and what the boss want for me. I'm gonna do. No rush.
Nice. Well, this is something I've been dying to talk to you about and ask you. I'm a huge fan of the IVC stuff. Okay, and for me, you were the original no holds barred fighter before it was MMA, and to watch you there, you know, you reminded me a lot of the similarities to Mike Tyson. You know, Mike Tyson was, he was a scary guy. You were scary. You looked like a monster out there. I just wanted to pick your brain a little bit and see, you know, what was going on back in those days in your brain. Like how, you know, do you still seem to have that killer instinct, you know, but was it different when it was no holds barred, when it was no rules, when it was raw? You know, tell me a little about that.
No, but, you know, before I'm young and I compete, you know, and I compete a lot of Muay Thai, and I feel like as the Muay Thai fight with no gloves, no, like it's a little bit different, no, because we use the head, we kicks in the ground, no, and that's really interesting because no rules, we can put the finger in the eyes, we can hit the balls, but we have a man rules, we don't do that with the opponents, yeah. But if you wanna do, you can do, no, but. I'm so glad for that rules coming, no? Because yeah. Man, this makes this sport better for me practice.
Well, you know, with the rules, you know, there's makes it a lot more active sometimes. You know, with the stand-ups and everything. Do you think that the intensity is still just as high as back when there were no rules?
No, it's a different time. You know, it's different fighters and different time. I think that time is good for the sport, but. Right now we're fighting like professional. We have rules, we have gloves, we have time. That's is totally better right now, more safe.
Nice, absolutely. Well, real quick, one more thing. Going to the Pride days, you did a lot of stuff, man. You were 5 years undefeated as the champion. That's possibly the longest reign ever for any combat sports competitor. What is one moment there in Pride that stands out? Was it Sakuraba? Was the first Sakuraba victory? What is the number one, most memorable moment for you?
It's hard to nominate with just one moment, you know, because I have a lot of good moments over there. I think my first fight with Sakuraba, there the Wanderlei Silva born, because after that everybody know my name around the world, and after that I start one fight after other, you know. My first two fights with Rampage there is a really good fight. My first fight I won the tournament with him, you know? And I have the good moments over there, and I'm so glad about my career. I'm so happy for fighting for the best guys in the world, and I'm so happy for me for building that name and have all that fans follow me for more than 10 years. I'm so honored for having all that guys with me.
Nice, and of course, it's led into this beautiful facility you have here. Before we round it up, is there anything anybody you want to give a shout out to? Any of your students that are getting ready to fight? I know Jorge's getting ready for a big fight with UFC. What do you have on the table here with the Vaughn Training Center?
Yeah, I'm heavy. I make a lot of guys debut. No, we have 50 guys make his first amateur fight this year. And you saw this sparring today, we have more than 30 guys. And I'm so happy for building these guys from nothing. And the guys make it the first amateur fight, second. And we have we're gonna have next week, we're gonna have 5 guys fighting. And every weekend we have like a 5, 6, 3. Every weekend we have the guys compete. And amateur, and we start to have like a 10 pros, 10 or 15 pros, and we try to help the guys with the sponsor, the all things, you know, the training. We bring different coaches to teach the class, and because I know what these guys need to do, because I do know, I know the way for the guys to be a champion. Who training hard gonna have success.
Well, man, I thank you so much for your time, man. It has certainly been an honor. We're looking at the axe murderer, Wanderlei Silva, Casey Oxendine, with MMA Inside the Cage.
Here it is. It's your MMA Inside the Cage main event of the week.
Tail off the tape. It's a 4-centimeter reach advantage for Mark Vinstaden. He's also 5 centimeters taller than Nolan Swanepoel.
Are you ready? You ready?
Fight! White trunks, Swanepoel in the black and white trunks. This is going to be an interesting battle. A lot of people want to see this fight.
bro. I can't.
Very well, he was in a very bad spot. He was in big trouble with the choke on the side and then for the guillotine as well. Did incredibly well. It's a slip from Nolan and Martin immediately trying to take advantage of it. And Nolan puts Martin back down on the ground. He's going to walk into the mound. Oh, 39 seconds to go in this round. Comes in, lands another shot. And Nolan again grabs the hold of that ankle. Martin doing very well, just sort of walking over and getting out of trouble.
That's the first round done and dusted. Incredible action.
Ready.
Swanepoel.
Ready.
Putting their bodies on the line here. Round two about to get underway.
Oh, nice jab by Martin and then a nice kick. 1-2 level by Martin. Nolan rushing in, as you can see Martin sit off with it.
Sutton's ribs couldn't take it anymore. They had to get out of there.
Very nicely. He just waited for the right moment. Felt Nolan's weight shift a bit, and he moved over and he got the sweep.
Pinned the one arm. Swanepoel.
Getting up to that crucifix position. Lands a big body shot on Nolan. Nolan's going to try and flip it over here. Just to avoid the shots. Martin landing nice elbows from top position. Now landing some more shots. Elbows as well. Putting on a neck crank. Big neck crank. Nolan spins out of it. It was a big down. Big hole.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Ian Pinar stops this bout 2 minutes and 20 seconds into round number two to the winner by TKO. Martin, the Punisher von Straden.
Advanced Sports Labs is always a great experience. You go in, you get your blood drawn, they take care of all the paperwork for you, they send your results to the commission and to the promoter, so I can just focus on being a professional fighter and getting on the fight.
Advanced Sports Labs. Expedite your blood work today at AdvancedSportsLabs.com.
Are you ready, America? Then let's get it on with Fight Now TV. Your front row seat, 7 days a week to experience all the hard-hitting action, news, and entertainment from around the fight world. From world-class boxing events.
Here we go, the main event!
To mixed martial arts showdowns and other combat sports matchups.
Here we go!
Fight Now TV delivers the hits and more. Fight Now TV also offers unrivaled access to the fighters and insiders who make the fight game happen around the globe. As we go from the training camps to the weigh-ins, press conferences to the matchups, Fight Now TV is there before and after every bout. Fight Now TV also features original series found only on Fight Now.
There you have it.
Stop on by.
It's time, fight fans. Your channel has arrived. All the fights, all the names, all the action. Call your television provider and tell them you want to get it on with Fight Now TV.
MMA Inside the Cage, brought to you by Advanced Sports Labs.
Well, it's time to say goodbye, and that means we have to say goodbye to Casey as well. You make sure to stay out of trouble, brother, when you're in Sin City.
Well, brother, now that we got the Ultimate Fighter tryouts out of the way, we've just been spending the rest of that time hanging out at the Vaughn Training Center, getting some good work, a couple of lumps and bruises to boot. But, brother, I will be back next week to settle up.
Now, I'm taking the curtain call for this episode. One event that had all the makings of an epic event was the Fighters Only World MMA Awards. Some of the bigger names in MMA showed up. The silver-tongued and volatile Chael Sonnen was the host, and it was the beginning of a big weekend in MMA. That being said, this event did not deliver. Just a few things that went wrong on this event that we're going to hit up right now. Average production, way too many flaws considering this is the showcase of a multi-million dollar industry. Aside from Chael, the comedy was poorly planned and executed, and each time a fighter couldn't accept an award, we had a 300-pound mess up there in Big Country Nelson. One time, okay, two times, still funny, five or six times, pure laziness on behalf of that show and their writers. This is the fastest rising sport in the world. Let's get it right, guys. Now, you can find us online at our official Facebook page. Follow us at MMAITC or email us at MMAInsideTheCage@gmail.com. On behalf of Casey Oxenine, I'm Cyrus Fees, and we'll see you next week inside the cage.